new mums and their babies are in the spotlight for a study on how they cope during recent natural disasters. Baby formula was scarce and many new mums found themselves in unexpected trouble.
To bottle or breastfeed, it's long been a difficult issue for new mums. But when Kelly Farquhar lost her home during the floods in Brisbane, her milk supply suffered.
I was overwhelmed by anxiety the whole time, you know, just feeling like I could be sick. So tensed the whole time.
Their infant needs just to spend time suckling, which may be very difficult in the middle of a natural disaster.
Because of the disruptions, five-month-old Adam needed extra attention. His parents, though, were dealing with the trauma of losing everything they owned.
All of a sudden, he was like a newborn, wanting to just be fed constantly, and he was sort of really restless and irritable.
When Adam became seriously ill with dehydration, Kelly had to give him formula. That was a challenge at the evacuation centre.
We had to do something about it. I was really worried it would get to the point where he would have to go to hospital.
It's stories like these that will form part of a new study at the University of Queensland. Researcher Ruth Newby is looking for 1,000 families who were feeding infants under two during a natural disaster.
We're trying to get as much information as we can across the broad spectrum of families who are affected with infants under the age of two.
That information will help the government and emergency services better respond next time.
Maybe we don't really understand how difficult it can be to feed infants during natural disasters.
No matter which country a natural disaster occurs in, infants' needs remain the same, so it's hoped policy developed from this study can be used by authorities around the world.
I think it's very worthwhile if we can improve practice and make things better for new mums.
Contact Ruth if you can help. Chloe Baker, 10 News.